started, so he came from Detroit to here in San Diego about 2 years ago. And he has a very interesting background. He started at home automation, then worked in software, and then moved to server and database development, machine automation and development, and now web development. My goodness. So now he's going to tell us all about using your current project to make the next one better and faster. So, without further ado, Jason Adams.
Hey everybody, how are you doing? Thank you for joining me for the last one today. I appreciate that you're taking the time. I know it's kind of the end of the day, so we're all starting to wind down, but I appreciate that you're here with me here. So let's start off with Sherlock Holmes. So Sherlock Holmes and Watson, they're camping, they're in the woods, they're on some case. This case is taken from the woods, and it's the middle of the night. So Sherlock rolls over to Watson and says, "Watson, wake up. Wake up, tell me what you see." And Watson stares up in the sky and goes, "I see millions of stars." Sherlock goes, "What did that tell you?" Watson says, "Oh, astronomically, that tells me there are millions of galaxies, millions of planets. Astrologically, it tells me that Saturn is in Leo. Horologically, it tells me that the time is about 3:15. Theologically, the universe is vast and very significant. Meteorologically, it looks like it's going to be fine weather today." "Why, Sherlock, what does that mean to you?" Sherlock goes, "Watson, you idiot. It means someone stole our tent." Very often we get so caught up in our thinking that we fail to see and learn from the obvious. We don't see what's right in front of us, or in Watson's case, we can't see what's not right in front of us. And this talk is going to be really about developing the skill of learning and how it improves our lives and work. So it's going to be kind of interesting, right? Because we're going to talk about WordPress. I'm going to share some things that I've learned in WordPress and the fruition of this. But I'm actually going to be focusing more on learning itself. Because it's, you know, it's kind of the whole thing. Give a man a fish, teach a man a fish, and their name. And I'm also going to share with you kind of my story. Why is this such an important part of the way that I think by this point? And I emphasize, it's really hard when we're doing our daily grind. We have projects to do, and as you're finishing one project, you're thinking about the next project and how that next project So we're always moving on to the next thing. We're very much creatures of the next thing. And what I'm going to be encouraging you to do is to stop and to think. As you're going through your project, reflect, observe, discuss with your teammates what you have Fun fact, I got two things. One, my wife, no joke. The only question my father-in-law has asked me to this day that was like really serious, he's a real history buff. I met him for the first time, he was sitting across the table and he goes, "So, is it the Adams?" And I'm like, "Yes." And he goes, "Okay." Second thing is that it gets me free breakfast on the East Coast once a year at the Adams Estate. I haven't actually taken it up yet, but now that I know it's a possibility that there's free breakfast out there somewhere. So my father worked
machine.
So there wasn't a machine, so we spent 4 years making one. And inventing is really hard. Anybody here like invent something? I mean, I know like engineering kind of is inventing it itself, right? Okay, it's really hard, right? Like, there's nobody to call and be like, I'm stuck. I'm not sure how to tackle this problem. There's just something completely out there, and there's no clear solution. There's no existing framework. It's like going to build a website and realizing you have to make the internet first. and so we started over 6 times. When I say start over, I mean I literally opened up a new blank file of my code and I started over. And my last code was bad. Junk code or anything. It was just the wrong code. It was solving the wrong problem. And so what we had to do every single time was we would observe, here's what we have. Here's the data it's giving us. We reflect. It's the wrong data. And we didn't know what to do with it or whatever it was. And then we would discuss this and we would figure out what can this teach us? This isn't what we need. But what can it teach us anyway? And so we did that 6 times. And it worked. And actually it did so well that we were able to sell tests. That actually was the second version of the machine we sold on. My dad got special recognition during his PhD defense. It was awesome. And it taught me a lot about learning. When you have nothing to do but learn, you are your own source of how am I going to get closer to what I'm trying to achieve. You have to learn. And so what I want to share with you is a tool. So first I'll show this, and then we're going to start to get into some particulars for webby stuff so that you can, you know, either love this part or take that part, whatever you want. And so first I want to share with you, though, just this really simple tool. This is a line and a circle, so this is like napkin material right here. You ever just need to jot down, like if you realize having a moment here, you think there's something here, this is a great tool to do that with. Is called the learning circle. So I'm going to start with this. So the Greek has two words distinguishing for time. We have one word, time, it's time to go, time to be here, time is ticking, right? They have two words. The first word is chronos. Chronos is just linear passage of time. Now, don't ask Einstein, but it's fine. Right. So